Hello.
Hey.
What's up, bruh?
Cool, now I can turn off your stream real quick. Alright, there we go. Nothing much. Sorry, yeah, I've been playing a lot of Udyr. Udyr and Shyvana and Fiddlesticks, those are my three I play the most, but Fiddlesticks kind of sucks right now.
Isn't somebody doing too hot? Like, he's down there at, like, what, 49? Shyvana's at 46, yeah. But, like, Shyvana's such a flexible champion, I don't think people know what to do on her yet. People are, like, figuring it out still. Like, for example, like,
super strong,
Harvester Nashor's Sork Boots is at, like, 56.6% win rate right now, so, yeah, people are just building her wrong.
Yeah, I think too many people are going, like, AD. They're trying to, like, figure out if she's viable AD again or whatnot.
Yeah, and I'm sure she is, but, like...
Yeah, it's fine. You know, she's flexible. She can build pretty much whatever she wants, so she's but very
just,
flexible.
But just the way most teams pick AP is usually the correct choice, because you've typically got an AD top laner and obviously an AD bot laner, right? So unless you got, like, fucking Zyra support or an Azir mid lane, you don't really have much of an option.
Yeah.
You have to go just AP to round out your damage profile.
Yeah.
And since we can now go AP frontline...
I've never tried it. So when I picked her up probably 4 or 5 months ago, my buddy kept telling me to do it. He introduced me to you, and so I started watching. And so I go full burst, and being in low silver, it's definitely something super viable. And I've been playing it this season, and it seems very strong.
Yeah, Shyvana's a very strong pub stomper, because, like, the game, nobody knows how to fucking end a game properly, so the game just goes long enough you to start one hitting people. And they've also never seen a fucking Negatron cloak in their lives, so. That helps too.
Yeah. Well, for me, like, I love Udyr. He sucked last season. This season, he's so much better. He's got such a high win rate because of the items, being able to dash on people and slow them.
Super that's nice. His main problem, is he couldn't fucking get on top of anybody.
Yeah, he's
Udyr, 52. Holy shit! No, he's not doing too badly, huh? What's he building?
Yeah, he's doing great. So he likes...
Stridebreaker, yeah, I thought so.
Yeah, Stridebreaker.
That's like a mini flash.
Yeah, so for me, it's either Stridebreaker, if I'm losing and I'm just going to split the whole game, I build Triforce. And if I'm ahead and they're all, like, ranged characters, I build Prowler's Claw.
Mm.
And all three items work extremely well on them. Prowler's Claw is really, really good once you get ahead, because you can just dash on people. You can dash on the back line. Deadman's super strong.
Deadman's didn't have flat move speed on it before, did it? Just the passive?
Yeah, it was just the passive. So
yeah, so now that's stronger too, yeah. And Sterics is fucking nuts. Like, I'm looking at building Sterics on Riftmaker Shyvana, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
Damn.
If you just need, like, a beefy dragon to stand in front of a Kog'Maw or an Azir, you just go, like...
Yeah. We can still
you just go, like, Riftmaker or Nashor's for your early game, so you don't have to concede everything. And then you can go, like, Sterics, Visage, Gargoyle, since Visage amplifies shields now.
Yeah,
you end up with, like, a 3,000 life shield in teamfights. It's actually really, really stupid.
It's too much.
But you gotta trust your team to be able to do that, so.
Yeah, so one really, really big thing that I like doing is split pushing, right? Because in low elo, nobody knows how to split push. They don't understand macro
the
whatsoever.
Gates.
And split pushing, it can easily win you games. You can get fed off split pushing on your own, you know, just so much money in side lanes. And Shyvana with gold is terrifying, I think. She's one of the more terrifying.
I got
champs,
fucking PTSD from leaving the team alone too many times, and they just gotta get engaged on and run it down. I usually look the team fight when I'm playing backline Shyvana.
Yeah, I can understand that. If my team's shitting though, if they're garbage, I'll just leave them. I'll leave them and go get fed on my own, and then I'll look to team fight. If we lose by then, I don't think there was much I could have done anyways.
Mm-hmm.
But if I could take two towers and three waves of gold, and then come back in the next team fight, then. That's what I love to do, but that's low elo, and I'm here for coaching.
Yeah, as the jungler, you shouldn't be splitting when there's, like, Baron or Drake up on the map, obviously. So your opportunities to split are, like, pretty limited.
Yeah, the only time I can split is, like, I can split if Baron's up and then I go topside. That's the only way I can split. Or Drax's not up yet, but it's coming up. Like, I got a minute and a half, I can split bot side. You can't go top, like... So on and so forth. Same thing. You just split where the objective's at, and then you ask your team to go mid, and then they get mad at you and flame you, but then they all die, and then you take in. That was a win. I don't really want to do that one. It's actually one I had yesterday. Yeah, 8, 6, and 7, but I still lost. I think my team fed really hard.
Yeah. We can see what if you could have carried. Sometimes you can't, but...
Yeah, even still, I'm sure there's...
If you're everything perfectly at silver, it's really hard to lose.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure I got Dragon Soul this game too, though. I think my team actually just fed that bad.
Well, I guess Discord really doesn't like being a window capture, does it? I guess it's just to do a display capture if I'm careful. Make sure I've got nothing open, it's gonna get me banned. My folders are closed. My perfectly tame folders.
Nice.
I should be okay, as long as I'm careful. Display capture. Ah, the folders, yep. I'm in a good mood. I'm gonna go fetch a ginger beer.
Okay.
We're gonna get started here.
Ooh, do, do, do. Grabs 5 hour energy. I'm gonna open up a stream and talk with chat. Go. I've never been on a stream before.
Alrighty.
Ginger beer. I've never had ginger beer. Is it good?
Yeah, this stuff's from Australia.
Word? My favorite beer is Hoegaarden. It's a German ale.
Hello.
What the hell is this?
I have no idea.
I'm the Shaco from the Shaco Maokai duo a few days ago.
We don't want to listen to that idiot.
Is it that bad?
It's fucking, we're doing something here. Fuck off, dude.
It's true. I paid money for this.
Mm-hmm, that's right. Fuck that guy.
All right. Can you see my screen?
Uh-huh.
All right. Go ahead and play the replay then.
Actually, it stopped being live.
Stop being live? Oh. Me. Go fix that. Share screen. It did stop being live. Okay. Should be up now. All good? Can you still hear me?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Is the screen up and running for you?
What the hell is the scene doing? I fucking... Display capture, move that up. Yeah, there we are. Okay. Now we're doing something, dude. Fuck off.
Oh, man. Put down this 5 hour energy. Let me know when you're ready and you can see my stream and everything.
Yeah, looks good.
Okay. All right, I'll hit play.
Okay, have you watched my video? I just put out a video on AP builds in Season 11.
I have not, no.
That'll go into, like, itemization, what's good when.
Okay.
Okay, let's see here. First of all, what's my did you start?
How can I look at that? Where can I look at my items on this?
There's a button. See the die icon beneath all in the bottom left?
Yeah.
You click that and it says scoreboard.
Or display.
Scoreboard. In the middle?
Oh, wait, yeah. Yep, yeah, I
click
see
that.
It. Okay, yeah, here we go. I went
blue smite, good. Blue smite procs Dark Harvest. If you're running Dark Harvest, you should always be running blue smite.
Yeah. I just found out, I think it was this game too. No, it was the last game I played on Shiv where I stomped. I didn't know boost my proc Night Harvester either. I was wondering.
It does?
Yeah.
That I did not know. What the fuck?
Yeah, I blue smited him and a quarter of his health disappeared.
Jesus fucking Christ.
I was like, hold on, what's going on right now? I was so confused.
And that's why Night Harvester being nerfed by 50 damage.
Yeah, which makes sense. I think it'll still be better to run than Luden's Wave.
Yep.
Back in Shiv.
Against Evelynn. Bit sketchy with AP. Evelynn wins early duels with AP, I think, with Dark Harvest. Starting red side's good. You know how OP cards are now, right?
Why does it keep switching?
Double click your profile. That's directed camera. Double click your picture. That's the easiest way to get the camera onto you constantly.
Is this it?
Yeah. If it goes off it again, you can just double click your portrait on the left.
Okay.
Okay,
so you have to clear all the Krugs.
Yep. You can kite the medium Krug around the big one, by the way, to save some life, but honestly, I don't think it's going to fucking matter anymore. Like, you just probably just face tank them.
Yeah.
Because,
yeah,
like, next patch.
So fast and healthy right now.
Yeah, next patch. Like that used to matter, but especially next patch when they're buffing the jungle item to not give reduced AoE healing on abilities anymore. So we're going to be. Yeah, next patch, we're going to be Graves. We're just going to be able to tank everything forever.
Thank God. That'll be good for Fiddles, too. Fiddles used to not have to take pots. Now you have to take pots, and that's just it's dumb on Fiddle, who has a AoE healing, like, massive AoE healing. It's like, nah, jungle camps, fuck you. Thank God they're changing that, though. Like, a lot of junglers felt really weak. I was happy because Karthus got a big nerf from it. You have to be perfect at playing Karthus and kiting.
You only hit two of the wolves through either, by the way.
Yeah, I saw that.
While you're killing the camps, you can bring them towards the next buff. Like, the wolves won't reset until they're in the bush.
Oh, okay. I know that camps are supposed to reset a lot faster now, so I'm still trying to learn how to kite that correctly.
Now, it's actually paradoxical, because they run faster, but reset at the same rate, so you can drag them out faster, or farther, before they reset.
Oh, okay.
So if you're good, you can, like, you can clear really, really fast.
Yeah.
Like, what the leash you had, this is pretty slow.
Yeah, so... With Gromp, you just face take him now, right? You don't kite him out anymore?
Yeah, it's not really necessary. You just kill him and get your full health bar back.
Yeah. Yeah, so I was pinging because I knew he was bot side.
Yeah.
Sorry,
you can do a Gromp and Blue together faster, by the way. What you do is
you kind of put them together through your E through both of them.
Yeah, you do what I do.
Makes sense.
Yep.
You didn't see the E.
I don't know what I'm talking about. It's fine, I juked you. It's Faker, it's fine. Yeah, Mord's kind of pushed up. This is nice.
You didn't see.
He even has a ward down, he just ignores it.
Oh, yeah, it's silver, you know?
What the hell's going on here, dude?
I wanted to give her the kill.
So it's not really a player, it's gonna just feed the lead away anyway. You can worry about, like, giving kills over when they're on that one hit left. If they're not, just, like, beat them up more. Make sure there's no way you can get away. And honestly, you should be, like... Don't trust these fucking people, dude. Until they've proven themselves, don't fucking trust them. Just take the kill.
Okay.
You're committing your time for it. Okay, what are you buying? If it's not a recurve, it's wrong.
Yeah, see, I didn't even know about that.
If it's not a recurve, it's wrong.
I always
spending too much time buying? What the hell is that? That's not an alternator, is it?
Yeah, it's for, because I'm going to hit my ult soon, so I wanted the extra damage on a champion, because I like to gank the moment I have my ultimate.
Oh, God help us all. Alternator only procs in champion, right? Not minions. Yeah, so this is bad. This will give you zero clear speed.
Okay.
Like, when are you buying Horizon?
Wait,
that's a Harvester, doesn't it?
Say that again?
That builds into Harvester, doesn't it? I'm crazy.
Yeah.
Yep. Clear speed is still important. You're going to be wanting to start recurve every game.
Okay.
It also makes you, like, way harder to take advantage of. You can actually, like, duel people with it.
Yeah. Yeah, you have a bit stronger early game.
Yeah. Last season, Runic was too strong to ignore. And even then, I like picking up a dagger or two for clear speed. But now with Runic gone... And Nashor's being as strong as it is, it just makes more sense to complete the item. Rushing Harvester is good, but over the long run, like, having more clear speed to kill more things faster to get more money faster will scale you up at the game faster, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it makes sense. She is a scaling champ, she doesn't really have the best early game.
Uh-huh.
Comparatively to someone like Udyr, at least.
Seen a lot of face tanking camps. Okay, so you can usually get six earlier than you used to now, I think, too. Like I'm hitting level six like 6 minutes or before like 6:30 was pretty good.
Yeah.
And pathing back to your red's fine here.
Yeah, I didn't want to back with my ultimate up and dragon up.
Irelia rushed to QSS.
Yeah, she told me about it. I was like, why?
You could just go Wit's End and just beat the shit out of him anyway. I don't know.
Yeah. I don't
Whatever,
understand.
Buddy. Yeah, this looks good. Plain. It's gonna end up being an overreach, isn't it? Here's the Orianna, yep. Yep.
Yeah, we got the kill on the Eve, too.
You should have been aware Ori was moving down.
Yeah.
Like, she walked over Ori, too, didn't she?
Yes. Yeah, I saw her, I just wanted to kill on Eve.
No, that's, you're not gonna kill her from there. From that.
She
survives. Or does she?
Yeah, she died.
Did she walk back over the fire pouch? First it didn't kill her?
No, fucking Sivir threw out her ass axe thing too.
Oh well, you can't, it's still greedy because you don't know if she's gonna be retarded or not, you know?
Yeah.
You lost your flash for nothing there if she doesn't do that.
Yeah.
Chicken's actually hurt a good bit if you're hitting him without your W up. Would advise against. Yeah. The only camp that hurts you anymore right now is basically chickens. You need to like kill them quickly or kite them if your cooldowns aren't up. Mm-hmm. This isn't gonna work. That's not enough damage. You don't play much Shyvana, so like with more experience, you'll understand where your damage thresholds are at, and like where when you should ult and when you should just hold it. Because like you were never going to kill her there in a million years. You had no flash, you had no smite. She can just literally just run away from you because you don't have the movement speed to catch her because of her W.
Yeah.
I guess she had no mana for W anyway, but like she can just run away from you.
I think I looked at my money right here and I was really close to Night Harvester, so I decided to clear my top side.
Mm-hmm, yeah. You typically never want to back if you have a side of jungle to clear what's right there.
Yeah.
Like, I will usually only back and if I have, like, literally nothing better to do.
Mm-hmm.
Rift here is also good. Like, you didn't go for, like, Drake or Rift either. Like... Before you get, like... Your first couple of items, you're not really looking to fight, so, like, objective should be your priority. Like, you should have already done Drake by now. Like, especially in low elo, you can just, like, literally just eat yourself a Drake and take it. Like, nobody checks it, nobody gets fucked, nobody knows what the thing does. Typically, junglers, like, looking around, dicking around lanes, looking for kills, because they think kills win games, and they just don't. This Drake should 110% be dead by now. And so should Rift, honestly.
Okay.
Look to Blast Cone over the wall onto Drake at like 5:30.
Okay.
With AP, I like staying on Sight Ward as well, just to like watch my jungle entrances, and because your ganks suck anyway. But that's up to preference. Like, most good people, most, like, good junglers will tell you that not getting super is trolling. That being able to set my own vision to eat people. And, like, the only way I can really help my team in the early game is, like, put deep wards in. So. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The Evelynn's kind of low. No, 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 no. Nice. Good planning. Oof.
Yeah, I love these fast champs. Dodging
these
skill
shots. Embarrassing.
Yeah. I really messed up there.
Oh, there's the fucking Orianna just, like, running it.
I don't know what she's doing. She missed her ult, too, which was awesome.
Break is free here, yep. That ward should be down by now. You've got a ward specifically for this purpose.
Yeah.
You want Mordekaiser TPing into the pit and fucking everything up? Which is, like, the only real bad thing that can happen there, but still, like, just ward the pit.
Yeah, I ping her off to let her know that I'm not going to fight that.
Yep. Don't fight without your ultimate.
Yeah.
Never, never, never.
Yeah, people don't, especially as, like, AP or Shyvana.
Yep.
You've
got a ridiculous farm lead over the Evelynn. You're in such a good position.
Mm-hmm. I feel like I out-jungled her pretty hard this game, but she still had, like, double my kills, but I was up 3 levels on her.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
yep.
I always felt I could beat her in a 1v1.
Yep, you can't do that, man. Like, even if you get a billion kills, just, like, sharking around lanes, if you don't farm, you're still gonna be under-leveled, and you're still just gonna be dog shit in fights.
Yeah. Like, I pretty much double her CS. She has 3 more deaths than me, but she got twice as many kills. But I was so far ahead of her that I think it would have been pretty easy to 1v1 her.
And some indecision happening here.
Yeah, I think I go straight to Rift Herald.
Okay, this is a really late Herald, by the way. You want to do Rift Herald, but much well before 14 minutes. Because why?
Because you get the extra gold.
Yep. Then plate money, honey. Especially in, like, it's gonna be really important in season 11 too, because mythic item power specs are so huge.
Yeah.
So, like, prioritize Herald over second dragon if the timings are such. But if you're doing your job properly, and if you're, like, allowed to be free and fly, then you should have Herald dead well before second drake.
Yeah. So I think what happened right here was I saw her bot side hovering a lot, so instead of going to do my own camps, so I just take hers.
Yeah, that's something I don't do enough of myself. I'm too, like, conditioned that I'm fucking useless, and I just don't go for opportunities like that. Mm-hmm. What is this? You just showed on the map for no reason.
Yeah, that was dumb.
Yep.
Even I know that was just stupid.
Uh-huh. Yep. You want to kind of behave like your fiddlesticks on Shyvana. Like, you don't want to show on the map if you can help, but you want that paranoia in their minds. When you do show up, it has to be impactful. Just showing for no reason, unless you're not getting anything out of it. Just a bad idea. Recurve before AP on Nashers, by the way.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm definitely just gonna rush that first item from now on.
Yep. It's so good. The best chance for Shyvana this season by a mile is the fact that you can rush recurve bow. It's so much better than Stinger, it's not even funny. Especially if you're going, like, Bruiser and you can go into more aggressive Keystone. Recurve is broken. Okay, well aimed. Good.
Yeah, knock her back in the tower.
Oof, yep. That's a Night Harvester! It's fucking broken!
So much damage.
I have no idea. Can I move the map? Oh, yeah, sure. Because we don't need it right now, do we? Yeah. You're sitting real pretty right now, man. Like, with a few optimizations, this is generally what you want to be doing. You get a lead like this in most games, you'll sail to victory. And you walk right past Garomp. Had plenty of time to kill that. Okay, priority here is Evelyn. Can't see how neither of them died. Evelyn's the only big threat on their team. Going for her is way more valuable than going for Braum or Ori, especially since Braum can just block your E. You're good about finding opportunities to take her shit away. Like, look how, like, this Evelyn is in such a pit right now, man. If your team was just a little bit smarter, she'd be so far behind. Yep. Free Drake, because Evelyn died. Good.
So I think I AFK here. I expected to die, so I'll fast forward. I had an AFK, my wife needed my help with something.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you'll see I just stand here still. Yeah, and then I'm back in it. Yeah, so my wife like needed help with the car, she got it stuck. I'm stationed in Alaska and there, you know, 7 feet of snow.
Ah, yeah.
So I had to run outside and help real quick. And it's funny because even though I AFK'd, I'm still like miles above this the enemy jungler, like level wise.
Yeah, she ran it. She found another way, a new creative way to run it down. In the meantime, apparently.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. So I don't think the AFK thing is the reason why we lost for sure.
Yeah. Jeez. How does this even go bad? Like the only thing I can think of is that Mordekaiser just slash ult or something.
Watch my team. Like they start feeding their brains out. It's really, really bad. Like, I die quite a bit too, don't get me wrong.
People are too close to each other mid lane here. You should be hovering mid lane and helping them out. Taking red there is greedy. Like, whenever you see those circles on your minimap, like, you should be watching your one eye on your minimap constantly while you're doing camps. Mm-hmm. Get to the point where you can, like, do camps, like, without looking at them. And just watch the damn minimap. The entire time. When those circles get too close together, you start heading over. You don't even need to, like, move your camera over. If those circles get too close together, you know, action's probably about to start happening. So start moving and then look. That was bad.
Yeah, I don't know what I was doing there.
Respect the shockwave, dude. Just fed over, like, like so much money.
Yeah. I can't believe Eve flashed. It hit her, it was ticking on her, and she would have died, and she flashed.
Mm-hmm.
Threw me off. Mm. But she's Evelyn and OP, and so she's full health again.
Wow, the Senna does no damage.
She was targeting Braum for some reason, with his shield up.
Not really is gonna catch you, Orianna. She's gonna do it. You just wait. She's good. She'll catch her. She's going. Yeah. She's gonna get her. Look at her.
Chasing's such a big problem in this Elo. God damn.
Jesus, she wasted so much time. Yep, going topside's correct here.
I love getting Nashers.
Yeah, build
clear,
it first.
Super nice.
Build it first. Not even kidding.
I'm so scared to because mythics are so strong.
Nah, clear speed's so vital.
Yeah.
The on hit is honestly as strong as the mythic for Shyvana, at least until it gets nerfed. Like, it's 100 AP on it, right? So it's like...
Yeah, it's quite a bit of
40 AP. Damage on hit when you complete it. And you can triple proc it instantly. That's like as much as a mythic, as much as a Luden's proc right there, honestly. Mm-hmm. And it's like most of a Harvester proc. Next patch will be a Harvester proc after they nerf it. Yep, good. Ezreal inted there.
A charm lasted forever.
But trade.
I think I should have taken.
Yeah, trade killing. You had your flash up. If you had flashed up immediately after killing Ezreal, you might have been able to buy enough time to E Evelyn cleanly and kill all of them.
Yeah.
Instead, you let her charm you. Also, this is a very late Dark Seal you're getting.
Yeah, Dark... I think I just had an awkward amount of gold.
Yeah. Dark Seal's fucking broken. You should always, like... buy Dark Seal before Nashers.
Yeah.
Find a moment
season,
to get it.
That's what I did. Yeah, because last season I would end with an awkward amount of gold after doing jungle items, so I'd always just get a bit of AP and getting a...
Yeah.
Because I would buy the 650 jungle item, and then I would just buy a Dark Seal.
Yep, Dark Seal is insanely good right now, man. It's 350 gold for 65 AP if you get going with it. It's so stupid. Mm-hmm. Okay, you don't have an ult right now, so you can't really help with this. You should be hitting Drake for Fury, yep.
They all left. I don't have to fight. I can build Fury. I can continue doing the Drake. It worked out really, really well.
Yep, it's perfect.
That they chased.
Goddamn, that's three Drakes and you're about to have Infernal Soul. You should have won this game. Something must have really bad happened. You should be able to just win this no matter how bad your team is.
Yeah.
We'll see what ends up happening. It's probably they probably just like run it down, they get Baron or some shit, and then you just like... Or you get caught. Is there only two bad things that can happen? Let me know how that looks when it's on air. It's interesting. Oh, that's tragic.
I was so confused about where she went. Turns out it was just a second. Pinging her off. I hate when people take my jungle camp for no reason. Mm. Especially when I'm the one carrying.
Yeah. If they need like 100 for the next item, let them have it. But if not, fuck them.
Yeah, but 'tis the life of a jungler.
Okay, pushing this wave is wrong here. You should be with your team right now, because you know Evelyn's looking to flank them. Evelyn's just going to kill everybody here, it looks like. Kills the Senna. Kills the Sivir. Yep, if you're there, that doesn't happen.
Yeah.
That's a bad time to split. If you're there, if you're there, you don't lose two members. You can probably get an inhib off that. I don't think Evelyn's ballsy enough to engage on five people. Four with their cooldowns down, maybe, but not five. Jeez, fucking flame horizoned her, what the hell? Nah, man, you're too huge. Something fucking terrible must have happened here.
Mm-hmm. I was trying to look for the item where it's over 750 range. Because this is like, I think this is the first game where I decided like I want to build this. I know he's like 900 range.
Yeah, I don't like Harvester this early with Horizon this early with Harvester. Yeah, you shouldn't have did that.
I thought it was okay. Rom got it.
I don't think he needed to flash for that Ori. I think just Nii would have done her. You put yourself too far forward.
If I just lose her.
Especially with the Horizon proc, she would have died. Like, the thing about Horizon is it highly discourages you from doing plays like that, right? It's not a very flexible item.
It makes it super simple just to R your backline and then just pop E's or sieging. It's super, super strong when you're sieging.
Yeah, but you need a lead for it. Like, it's a defensible choice because you have a Malphite, but it's an AP Malphite, so he might just get popped before he can go in. But like I said, Horizon with Ludens is really good because you just do so much goddamn damage from the flat penetration on Ludens on a squishy target that the Horizon practice is so valuable. Yeah. It's not so much the case with the Harvester. I'd much rather go Cosmic Drive and have a much shorter cooldown on my E, especially since there's really like evasive champions on that team. Like, you've got a Braum that can block your E, you have Ezreal that can E out of your E, Orianna can W away from your E, fucking Evelynn can ult out of it. Cosmic Drive is so much better here than Horizon.
Okay. I think I was calling to give this Drake.
You can steal it. You are Shyvana.
Yeah. Yeah, I was just a little iffy. We didn't know where Eve was and Malphite wasn't there.
Using your E on Braum is incorrect. Especially when he has his shield up. Nah, it's never gonna work out.
Yeah.
Get the crab. Is this Evelynn ever seen a fucking jungle cap in her life? Jesus Christ. Okay, that was well aimed around Braum there. Yeah, here you just need to ult in the Ahri.
Yeah.
You just missed. Yeah. You could have killed her.
Yeah, missed my E.
Yeah. You could have killed both.
I didn't think she would run up towards me. It messed me up.
Mm-hmm. I mean, there's two of them there, so they're in forward mode.
Mm-hmm. And he doesn't have ult now.
Yeah, you see how risky splitting is, though? Like, you just got yourself killed for no reason. If you'd played with your team more in certain situations, I think you win this game easy. You're so unbelievably powerful. You just do so much goddamn damage. But now you're just dead for so long, and they get to like take a Nexus turret at least, or an Inhib turret at least. Looks like.
Yeah.
There's Senna doing damage.
Mm-hmm. Scaling up to what she needs to be.
I usually don't like Banshees, but this is not a bad game for it. God, it still feels so bad to use Banshees, dude. Like, it just got popped already from some stupid bullshit.
Yeah. It just wasn't a bad idea because, you know, Mordekaiser.
They have 3 AP. Like, I would only ever consider Banshees if they have like 3 or 4 AP. They have Ezreal too, so it's like 3.5 AP too, so it's really not bad.
You gotta think they're two fed people or AP also. So
but in most situations, Zonya's is just superior to Banshees.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Because you can hard engage with your R.
Yep. Not only that, but if like it does the job that Banshees does but better.
Yeah, Mordor's just so strong.
And just throwing yourself into the 16-4 Mordekaiser is a bad idea, dude.
Yeah. Thought we might get it with everyone we had there, but he just won.
Nah, that's just not knowing how strong Mordekaiser is. That's just ignorance.
Yeah.
Yeah, you did kind of throw this game pretty hard.
Yeah.
You had enough to work with to win this game, absolutely. This stupid Irelia still doesn't have Wit's End. No. You have to go in together, dude.
Yeah.
When someone gets that fed, you need the entire team, or you just don't engage with them? Three people's not enough? Two people's not enough? Going in there just chunked you out before the rest of your team got there for more firepower? Horizon was such a bad purchase, actually.
That was that.
Yeah. You definitely could have pulled this one out.
Yeah, I'd like to say I didn't play bad, but you know, there's so much more I could have done better, like, though.
You built
know?
A huge lead, but then you threw it all away.
Yeah. Everyone, I'm always gonna blame my teammates in silver, but man, that was rough. It was. I actually stayed really, really calm this game. I wasn't like tilted. I wasn't flaming. Because I felt like I did decent, and I knew there was stuff I could have done better, but...
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, there's definitely a lot more I could have done.
Yeah.
And if I want to climb out of silver, I gotta carry hard every game. Which I do with Udyr really, really well, but I know I can do it with Shyvana too. I think she's just as good as Udyr.
If not better, honestly. Like I said, way more flexible. Speaking of which, have you only been using Harvester on her for now?
Yeah, I love Harvester. Yeah, so much damage.
I haven't tried Ludens or Riftmaker.
No. I don't really like frontline Shyvana. I'll do it if I have to. Like an AP Bruiser type build. I have fun, like a lot more fun when I'm playing like AP versus Shyvana.
Yeah.
It just feels like when you see those E's when they land and someone's got like 20 health left, it feels so good.
Yeah, you can still do that with Riftmaker.
To try it.
Landing on someone with Riftmaker, you just tear their fucking faces off. It's actually crazy.
Yeah, Mordekaiser, I think, hard carried that game. That's all him. But, do I play a game and then try and go over what?
Let's do it live.
All right. And try and go over. Yeah. So I want to.
You understand why Horizon was bad, right?
No. But is it because I want to alt in and be close to the fight?
At the point you built it at, you're not getting enough value out of the passive for it to be worth it.
I think I used it wrong.
I would ult.
Maybe instead of ulting in, I should have just ulted like in my backline and just shot ease.
Yeah, you're ulting in too far, too much, too often to use Horizon effectively.
Yeah. Yeah, it makes sense.
If that's the way you want to play the game, then you shouldn't be building that item. And it's not always wrong. Like it's like our E-ing in is good with CC on our team, especially like Malphite.
Yeah, we had a Malphite. I was looking for that Wombo combo.
It's like our E-ing with him is pretty good. Like, Horizon's great fourth with Ludens, but not so much with Harvester.
Really?
Yeah, like fifth or sixth. Between Horizon and Deathcap is actually pretty close, the sixth item. I ran the math on it, it's actually pretty close. Like, yeah. Like Blue Pot Horizon is strictly better than Deathcap. For less money.
It's kind of crazy.
With, like, once you get to, like, the 400 AP build point.
Mm-hmm. I think it's crazy. Nashor's gives 100 AP now. I know you lost CDR, which really sucks.
Yeah.
CDR is really, really strong in general. But 100 AP, and wasn't it only, like, 40 attack speed before? 40%?
No, it was still 50.
It was 50? Okay, so you traded 20 AP for 20 CDR.
It's not going to be quite so worth after the nerf that's coming,
yeah.
But it's still pretty good. Just being able to build that, just being able to build the goddamn thing out of recurve is such a huge buff.
Yeah.
I get so fucking huge, dude. Absolutely love it. Early recurve is so good. I'm not a fucking joke at level 4 anymore.
Yeah, I usually when I'm playing Shyvana, I tell my team I can't play Shyvana this game. God damn it.
That's a lot of AP. Holy shit.
Yeah. Mind if I just dodge?
You could. Let's see how it plays out. Oh, damn, I got Mundo too.
Yeah.
Watch this guy pick fucking Rumble top lane or some shit.
Oh, man. Mordekaiser top lane.
Garo. Oh, so it's his name is Knife Cat. Yeah. Of course, he's gonna play that.
Yeah, that was. Yeah, I'm dodging
so,
this game.
Bruiser would be really good here since you're on frontline. And you're into like three bruisers. Jesus. Playing AD Bruiser here would be really good.
I do not want to. I do not want to play against this team with the team we got. Yeah, I'm dodging this.
Yep.
I usually wouldn't. Usually I would just go like Udyr here. And play Tiger Udyr, you know, but I want to get Shyvana coaching.
Mm-hmm.
I would definitely still play that. Like, I'm last pick jungle. I could play anything I want. That would work good. I think Graves actually would have been pretty decent there. But, yeah, I want to get Shyvana coaching. Kind of why I hired you. The Shyvana one trick.
Yeah.
Yeah. Alright, we got 5 minutes. So kiting out camps is still viable except, like, Gromp.
Yeah, like I said, it's like probably not gonna matter next patch, but like, you kite camps not to save health now, but to like do your clear faster, right?
Yeah, yeah, to get to your
just
next
get that those extra couple steps towards your next camp.
Yeah, I was watching you do it with wolves. Like you would run right past them and then
throw
E on the other side.
Yeah, the dogs are great.
For your next camp.
The chickens are fucking assholes though, man. Like the chickens just like they'll reset for like randomly. So I don't like taking the chickens farther than the bush. Like you can. And a lot of people do it. I just don't understand how the little ones reset.
Yeah, I think after a month of playing, I'll be more
like,
confident in kiting everything out.
If one of them does reset, it just fucks you up so much. I just don't even like risk it.
Yeah, especially early. Shyvana has such a fast clear. Like, you really don't want
to
fuck.
It's not
that
a huge
up.
Deal if one of the dogs resets on you, but the chickens just you have to go around that fucking wall. It's just such a huge pain.
Yeah.
Especially if it's like the one in like the back. It's usually the one in the back. That one back chicken is such a fucking asshole, dude. I hate that guy.
Yeah.
He's always on the resets.
Yeah. Usually my clear riot, like silver is crazy, right? So like all kinds of shit that can happen. But say it's a normal clear. I like to do a full camp clear to either back scuttle or to front scuttle, depending on where the enemy jungler started. Then just do the scuttle I'm at, and then I'll invade and take either their Gromp or Rap or Krugs, depending on where I started. And then I'll back, but that depends if I have lane prio or maybe if mid or top lane's pushed way the fuck up, then I'll probably go gank one of them, depending on where I start. But like, there's so many variables. But if I'm playing Shyvana, like
honestly, like I think that's kind of dead this season. The Krugs are too good. I think starting red buff is always better now since you kill Krugs early. Mm-hmm. And like, I think everybody else is doing the same thing too, because I'm never seeing anybody at blue side scuttle anymore. Like, they're always at They're always at they're the opposite scuttle since everyone's doing Krugs early since Krugs are broken.
Yeah, this I feel like
like being able to do Krugs twice before Drake is really big.
Yeah, that's true.
Like I used to rush Drake and be there at 5 minutes every game, but now I think doing another Krug cycle is more valuable. The camp gives you like it's like 135 gold in that camp, man. It's actually crazy. It's like half a kill is doing Krugs.
Yeah, it gives you the same XP though, doesn't it?
It's literally half a kill for just doing the fucking Krugs.
So they buffed it from last season?
Yes.
I thought they nerfed the medium ones and just buffed the small ones, so it
Because there's only three medium ones and six small ones, the camp as a whole is buffed.
Huh. Well, that makes sense.
Yep.
Yeah, and Shyvana wanted to take them all anyways, because she could do the small ones fast.
Mm-hmm.
So, that's a nice quality of life. Not so good for Udyr, but it's fine.
Yeah, they buffed the little ones by more than they nerfed the medium ones, and there's more of them.
I'll probably start red on your side then. Red's just good to start in general, you stay healthier, you clear faster.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's like, blue team Shyvana is way stronger than red team Shyvana now, because you got the stronger leash, and you get the Krugs early.
I think blue side's stronger in general.
Yeah.
Because if you take top
scuttle blue side has a higher win rate at Worlds, I think, too.
I mean, like, it's really good for sneaking dragons, too. Which both the champs like play Shyvana and Udyr, they love doing. Doesn't even matter if you get scuttle crab.
Easy access to Drake,
Yeah. That's huge.
And since you'll be taking, since you'll be trading bot scuttle for top scuttle, you can just cone over the wall, and they think it's like people don't understand that that cone is there, man. Like they really don't.
Yeah, they think they're safe. Like he's not a drag. I continue clearing. Like since my bot lane doesn't have prio, and then all of a sudden drag's gone, and you just walk out of the pit. They're like, what?
You don't need fucking prio either. Like you just do the Drake. Like just fucking do it.
Just do it because just they think they're safe. Yeah, they think they're safe. You just go. No, I was saying that the enemy jungler's like, oh, it's safe, but I can't do Drake because my bot doesn't have prio, but I know it's safe, we're fine.
I don't even fucking look at the lane states anymore, man. Like, the success rate is so high, I just do Drake. I don't fucking care. What it works down to, works out to is, like, 70% of the time, nobody sees me, and I get it scot-free. Like, 20% of the time, somebody sees me, but it's too late, and I get the Drake and get out. Like, 5% of the time, I have to, like, smite the Drake away from them, and, like, 5% of the time, I die and lose Drake. It's literally, like, it's such a high success rate. Just going for it is such a big percentage play. Because people are stupid, they don't check it. Even in Diamond.
Nice.
Yeah, so I'm gonna be yelling at you this game to do, like, a 530 Drake.
Makes sense.
Yep.
You did Drake, just think about this,
right? When was the first time you did Drake in that game?
Like 10 minutes?
Yeah.
Probably?
10 minutes, yeah. You had three Drakes by the end, right? If you just fucking do Drake early, you have Infernal Soul on your team.
Yeah, maybe that's enough.
It might have been different. Like, just from that alone. You only started to lose control of the game at like 20 minutes. If you get Soul 4-0 at 20 minutes, it's really fucking hard to lose the game, especially with Infernal Erosion.
Yeah. Yeah, this is a good Shyvana game. Tanky top laner would be good. Or a Renekton or something would also be really nice. Who are you banning in Diamond right now?
Mumu.
You are?
Mumu, then Hecarim.
Yeah. Yes. Mumu's so busted right now, it's fucking ridiculous. Mm-hmm.
Yep. They buffed him to compete last season, and now the new items just made him insane.
Yeah. Yeah, it's fucking crazy.
Transcendence. Transcendence. Over Celerity.
Okay.
Transcendence is mandatory. It's 10 haste, dude. And we don't have the Nashor CDR anymore, we need it.
Makes sense.
And attack speed is fine since you're going Harvester. If you're going Ludens, I highly suggest going the haste route on top of that. Since it's gonna be a really long time for getting haste at all. If at all. Yeah, Gathering Storm Transcendence, I'm pretty sure, is the meta right now.
Okay.
Reset looks good, yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, three people I can one-shot.
You have frontline and engage. This looks like a great comp for you. This should be free.
Yeah, I can one-shot three of them. Should be able to poke.
Actually, who's support? Is support MF? Or do they dodge?
Probably.
Okay, I guess we're taking it, huh? Okay, this should be great for you. The only bad target is Garen. You'll even hurt Warwick a good bit.
What's the percent HP AP item? Also gives health.
Demon Embrace.
Yeah, Demonic Embrace, yeah. You think that's a pretty decent item on her?
Not for your build, no. It's good for for Riftmaker builds.
Or Bruiser.
You're already going to be picking up 450 health from Harvester and Cosmic Drive. You don't really need anymore.
Okay.
You should be aiming backline over frontline, honestly.
Yeah.
I'd much rather have a Zonya's or something. Zonya's death cap. Warding trinket. It'll automatically start it with it. Yep, do what I do. Go topside, drop the ward in Pixel Bush at like 105. Ping your bot lane to go watch your red buff, or watch your entrance to your jungle.
Yeah, they are.
They need to be further up than that. They're gonna get picked there. Oh, Jesus Christ, the silver. Oh, God. Oh, God, they're not doing anything. They don't have your back, bro.
Shen's doing something. Why? What? I don't know.
God, Jinx, that's so sketchy. Jinx should not be there right now. I just don't fuck with him. You'd be late if you'd fuck with him. Not worth it. He wins hard level one.
Level 3.
He's got a potion though. I guess it was new since his work. Maybe saving the money.
Yeah, like Udyr, you don't take potions. I'm pretty sure Warwick's the same way now too. You just don't take potions. I guess Pike's AFK.
Even Shyvana doesn't really need it.
Yeah, honestly. This is gonna be a remake. Are you shitting me?
It's good. Show me a good clear. Yep, don't smite.
Yeah.
With a shit leech like that, just kill it with two E's. Then that lets you smite this. Yep. Bring them left while you're killing them.
Got them all.
Yep, they're burning. Just run.
Yeah. I didn't think I would get the last two.
Yeah, Pike is back. It's not a remake after all.
Pike showed up.
But your bot lane's behind now.
Yeah.
Yep. Good. They hurt you more than they needed to. Kiting could have been better, but that's the general idea. I'll pull them to the right when I pull the camp. Just give me like a little bit more room to like drag them over more distance.
Yeah.
Why are you killing the small ones first?
Huh?
Don't kill the small ones first. Kill the big one first.
Just keeps me healthier, I thought.
Nah. Speed is so much more important than health. Health doesn't matter anymore. Remember?
Yeah.
You're gonna smite and get like a billion health back on this gromp. Then the gromp itself is gonna heal you. You got no E-procs in the big wolf? Uh-oh.
Oh, he got it.
Yep.
Fucking got my blue buff. I went for the smite.
Shen is coming. This should be fine. Oh, you could've killed him easy. And then flashed out. Your flash is a bit early there. You should proc DH. Oh, go in! It's fine. Okay. That was very dumb what they just did there.
Yeah. Thank God my laners weren't watching, actually.
Yeah, you were too skittish on your flash there. You had, like, several hits left on you. And the Garen was still, like, a good bit away. Even if he flashes on you, you kill the Warwick before Warwick can kill you. You have to do your Gromp and you'll have a good amount of money to recall on.
Yeah, not too bad. Two assist out of it. Team got ahead because they're dumb. Mm-hmm. Picking right now. That's not me just stopping, I promise.
Yep.
Blaska, gotta love it.
Mm-hmm. ping, yikes.
Yeah, it's me every day.
Yep.
Gotta love it.
Yep, recurve Red Ward. Okay. Now, you will feel the power. I've shown you the light.
Yeah, I'm kind of excited. I've never tried this. This could be pretty cool. I think I do Krug straight into this.
Yep. That cone spawns between 5 minutes and 5:30. It's completely random.
It's random? Oh, I thought it was just 5:20.
Nope.
Every time.
Nope. Half the time I get there at like 5:15 and I'm doing a fucking rain dance for like 15 seconds.
Jesus.
Waiting for it to spawn. It's usually like a 5:29 cone or some shit when that happens. Yep. But doing Krugs first means you won't have to wait on it, no matter what. And that's unlucky. Have to kill him. No choice anymore. Yep. Do Drake.
Yeah.
Do Drake. Don't even look. Just do Drake. Fuck it. Fuck these people. I don't care what they're doing. Do Drake.
Scared him away. Scared him away. Scared him away. Come out.
The ward is bad, actually. He's still doing it.
Now
you reset.
No, he's not. Away for a second. He might just back all the way off.
Yeah, you have pop power. Just kill Drake. You have smite now. If he can test, Pike should just kill him. But you want to put that ward at the entrance to the pit instead, like right in front of Drake, so that you can, if there's a ward on top of that scuttle vision, you can check for that too. Because I don't even check the damn Drake before I jump over. I just jump, dude.
I feel like I probably would have died there if I did that.
Nah, the Drake was hitting Warwick. I don't know what this guy's doing. He's not going to kill you.
Yeah, he can't kill me.
If he had his ult, maybe. I think his ult was down.
I don't have W here.
Yep. He'll be fine.
Yeah, as long as Warwick
shouldn't fuck with you in your top side since you just died. Or since you just got forced back. I don't know. He might fuck with you.
I think I'll just back here.
You can do red, and the red buff will heal you.
Yeah, if Warwick comes though, I'm just dead.
Is he though? He's gotten punished for it once, remember? Just enough.
Yeah, that was the best cutting I could do.
You got smite, you can finish your clear.
Oh yeah, you're right.
You're gonna be 6 off of Grump. Look to go mid with it. It's usually a waste of time to gank a Garen.
Yeah.
Okay, look at mid. You might be able to get Garen out. Yeah, kill Garen. Yeah, Garen. He took turret shots for no reason. He's a fucking idiot. One of you should kill him. Nice. You can do Rift now. And back with the Empowered Recall. Hey, don't let him do that. Fuck that guy. Steal it. He doesn't have smite.
Smite would have been nicer. I tried with my Q.
Yeah, bit indecisive there. If you just, like, fucking flashed at him, it would have forced him away, I think. You had mid prio. Yeah, he went for that so early. Most people don't do that.
Yeah. Yeah, that sucks. I really want that too.
Boots Dark Seal, and I think you have enough for Blasting Wand too.
I don't have enough for this, do I?
Boots, Dark Seal, Blasting Wand. Yep. And a ward too. That's such a clean buy. Get a ward too. I don't dump back right now, it's too late.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, once I walked down and you said get a ward, I was like, shit. Stays. And I hit these once.
If MF doesn't back off, she's dead. You can kill MF here. Cue the thing, go kill her.
Yeah.
Just go. That's fine. Two flashes. Back off now. Good. That's one dead. Two dead. Excellent. Good. Well done. Yeah, the best way to gank on Shyvana is when people are greeting for turret plates like that, because you don't gank anyway, like, most of the time, so people could, like, think you don't exist, and then you remind them that you exist when they're too far up to back off.
Just too much damage?
Yep. By the time they see you, it's too late.
Quite a bit of damage with my E.
Once you have that much room to chase people down, they can't escape.
Still have to do quite a bit of damage.
See what, like, look.
Very nice.
Like, when you see, like, waves crashing, like, you should be there. Like, if they greet for plates, you punish every time.
Yeah.
It's such a high success rate ganking off of turret plates. Because you can ult over the wall.
They have TP? No, they just got back extremely fast. I guess it is an MF. She runs back really fast.
Dark's on Drake right now. You need to be a Drake. This Warwick is highly objective focused.
I gotta play on the unlock screen.
If you just ult over the wall, you might be able to smite the Drake away. Just don't even look, just go. He's on it right now. I think he kills it super slow. You can do the thing over the wall too, the cone. Yep, just fuck this guy, he'll die. Well done, now that trick is yours. Look at that. See, you wouldn't have done that if I hadn't told you, right?
Yeah.
Decisive!
Do my bot side here and then back.
Yep. Yep. If you have things to do, don't back. Yone might do something cute. What is Jinx doing? What the hell?
Take a tower. I gotta get red buff here and I might be able to gank him.
Yep. Playing with locked camera is bad. We'll talk about that later. We'll talk about the gank now. That looks really good. Yep. Onto the Diana. Yep. That could have been combo cleaner with Diana. Not bad. No, protect the Jinx. Wow, he really wants that, doesn't he? Wow, he's so bad.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. Oh, man. Oh man, okay. Well, this game should be unlosable. Nashers?
Ew.
Medjaz?
Nashers and Boots?
Nah, Medjaz too early. Yeah, you want Mythic first? Go Mythic.
Before my Boots?
Yes.
Okay. Path from my Raptors because I did this. Then
right now, haste is more important to you than cooldown reduction, or haste is more important than a penetration, rather. the proc on Harvester is just insane. It'll be way more damage than just boots.
Makes sense.
That's what I do. You can make the argument for growing boots for the faster power spike, but you're delaying mythic by a good amount already for Nash. Is not really, don't really like. Oh, that's a kill, I think. If you don't like let him ult you. Yep, that's enough damage.
I want these minions.
Yep. Get all that. Mm-mm.
Yeah. And
if she just suspects you, you can kill her.
Yeah. I don't think she knows. Close. Alright, go back to clearing.
Yep, and Rift is up too.
Yep. That's exactly where I'm going. It's probably on it.
It's a little early for second Rift, but yeah, check to make sure Warwick's not on it, because he's... Yep, there he is. Good call. You smited away. Good. Nice one. And you're now 3 levels up, and he's just ruined. He's just fucking ruined, dude. Yep, you see what we can do to these silver shitters?
Mm-hmm.
You're not a silver player, you're at least platinum.
Like to think so.
Mm-hmm. What the fuck you doing, dude? I'm an Alaskan. I'm still better than you. Get fucked.
Yeah.
Go fuck those people. Fuck them. That Vayne is one hit. Garen can't one-shot you. Not sure about the flash. Yeah, you flash for no reason, like Garen block your shot.
Yeah, I was hoping would give me a range to hit at least.
You're flashing too early. Like flash ulting like you're doing doesn't get you any extra distance. Like okay. Like either flash and then ult or ult and then flash land before you flash. You just like got no extra distance from that. The ult will complete and you'll go faster, but you won't go farther.
Okay, I almost have enough for my full mythic.
Yeah. Oh, you're gonna be so strong. You're gonna fucking one-hit somebody, dude.
Should probably just give power. I don't think they can stop the siege. Better than dying.
Yep. Get all back and go and like flip mid to help them if necessary.
That's what I'm trying to do right now. Oh man, they just shredded.
Hmm. And try to get away from playing on lock camera too. Like I generally hate it.
Okay.
But it takes a long time to get used to. So.
Yeah, I started. I didn't even know you could.
You should be watching Drake over Yone right now. Looking to steal Drake. Be playing on lock camera means you have no idea what health Drake's at. Good shot. Okay, Drake was still, like, nowhere near dead, so you'd play that correctly. I couldn't see what health it was at, because your camera was, like, out of the way. You could have positioned your camera to watch Drake and the fight, is what I'm trying to tell you.
Yeah, that makes sense. I don't know what to go here.
If it was unlocked?
What do you recommend?
Just bank the money, I'd say.
Just keep it?
Your next build is, Cosmic Drive, but I wouldn't sell the ward for it when you're still looking for Magi's and boots. Those are your next priorities right now. I'd much rather get that over like a Cosmic Drive component.
Yeah, you want the movement speed?
Sell potions for Tome? Nah. I mean, like, the potions don't really mean much at this point, but no, we're going for, we want Magi's, dude. We want Magi's and boots right now. Normally, yes, you should spend your fucking money on whatever you can, but, like, in this situation, like... If the Dark Seal wasn't stacked to 10, I would say, I would say you're right into do that, but... This next time should be Magi's, I think, over Boots.
Yeah, with how far ahead I am.
That would give him another Mythic Passive stack, too. Yep, oh, there's Warwick. Their entire team is there, don't do it. Look at that Vayne in top lane. Okay, she backed off good. It's just clear your shit. They might be looking, yeah, okay, they're going top lane. Go top lane and fight. It's it'll be a 4v4. Yep, use that so it doesn't expire. Yep. Okay, if Pike is smart, he's looking to pick something here.
They just left.
There he goes. He could initiate on someone better, but I think the Garen still dies. Don't do anything here. You don't have the damage. Yeah, actually, it forces him away from the tower for Rift Herald. It's not too bad. Yeah. I wouldn't have shot the Garen there. I would have rather held on to the cooldown for this Yone. You see? You need him? Okay, you hit him barely. Could have hit both. And Pike's just gonna go crazy here. Nice.
Right, Pike.
Yep. Hitting the Garen under the turret was largely wasted there. You lose this, I think. Yep. Hey! Oh! Ah! Maybe! Hey! That was ballsy. I like it. Okay. I fucking like it. I wasn't sure about that one.
Yeah, me either.
I came down to one auto.
My asshole puckered.
I would have once you one-shotted the Yone, I would have rather like kited it into the bush to the bottom to get like cooldowns recycle. I was not sure you would beat that MF in a straight up fight, and I have no idea how you did it.
Bad.
Yeah. But like, she's 2 and 10, and you're so ridiculously fed. Is the point? Like if you're not this fed, you int there is the thing.
She's also going AP with like support MF.
Be careful with that. Uh huh. Yeah, that too. I didn't appreciate she was AP either.
Yeah.
Even so, man. Like, if she's not 2 and 10, you lose that.
Yeah.
If like you have to be so far ahead to win that fight. You want to be careful about taking fights like that?
I think I was going to die anyways at that point because I overstayed, so I just tried turning.
Yeah, and I think you could have escaped with one hit after you killed the Yone. If you would want to run to the bush to the bottom, that would have been the safe play. What if you eat a cooldown and then go back in if you can hit her? Nice. Fuck these people, you're so strong. You should have shot the Vayne there instead of the Warwick. Yep, you see how well Shyvana works with Pyke?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This is unlosable at this point. You're so big. You can Baron. Just go Baron.
Yeah.
Ping Baron. Yeah. Like, you have to, like, grab these people by the fucking leash and, like, lead them to victory.
Yeah, every like, game, dude. Every
like,
game.
They don't know what to do, man. Like, pink the pit. Pink the pit.
Yep.
And no one's around.
Yeah, we shred with me and Jinx. Yep.
I want to see a good smite here. Not bad. 400 ping, that's pretty good. Drake's coming up, don't reset. Go Drake now.
Yep. Go Garen here.
Now save your ult if you can. You're going to need the ult to steal to get Drake. This Warwick sucks and he's tilted. You can steal Drake easy.
Mm-hmm.
Does anybody have wards?
Yep, okay. There's a pink. That's nice.
One E on a priority target forces them to concede Drake. You can E them over the wall. R over the wall and E. Yeah, no vision when you did that. Nice hit. Yeah, they just can't... They can't repel firepower of that magnitude!
I killed him. Nice.
Fucking fire batch.
Just autoing and then just shoot an E over real quick.
Pass okay. Drive. Need a little bit more money. I would just stay on the map and fucking kill everything until you have it. Whatever. Wait, why are you going Horizon, man? Come on.
I'm sorry, it's habit and I didn't know what to build. Did you say Cosmic Drive?
Yeah.
Anything built into that I just built?
Nope.
I love E's pretty much up permanently. Or I mean, W.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Oh, you didn't even build the right item. Like, you should have drive by this point, so it should be, like, up all the time.
Yeah, I got Medjai's fully stacked. That's fucking crazy.
Mm-hmm.
I want to get my ult up before I go.
Yep. Always do this. you are worth jack shit without your ultimate.
Yeah.
Just muscle in and cue the inhib. It's fine. They can't fight you. Bit late on Yuri there, but you're on 100 ping, so could have killed the Yanezi. You know where he's going back to when he does his WN? Sketchy flash there, buddy.
Yeah, I'm just, the game's over right now. So
I mean, yeah, but it could be more over.
Yeah, it's true.
You could have shot that vein. It could be more over. Poor man. I want the perfect game. Don't you fucking die on me. You're 5 levels out of this, Warwick.
Yeah, he's having a bad time. She doesn't do anything.
Wow. Good shot. Yeah, this is exactly how you want to play when you don't have your ultimate. What you could be doing is looking to queue minions as they come out of the Nexus to get your ult back faster in this situation. Just eat that vein. Got him. Easy fucking game.
Oh, Penta.
Where's the Penta? 8 seconds.
They're all dead.
That might be enough time.
Tell Garen
to give it to you in all chat right now. Aww, scumbag Jinx, reporter. Report that fucking Jinx.
Oh, they took my Penta. Damn. Good game, though.
Yeah. Just
but,
do that,
do
forehead.
Do I look like a silver one player?
Nope. Not at all. That's at least plat. Just do that, forehead. Literally just do that. That was damn good.
Silver's so fucking easy. So dumb. I know I make mistakes all the time, though. Like, that game, I don't think there were too many mistakes.
Nope, not really. No big ones, anyway.
Did I not get all the honors? They probably honored each other.
Yep. The only thing you did that fucking triggered me was you didn't buy Cosmic Drive.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm fucking salty. You're building non-optimally.
Dude, you're like, it's so good. Like, imagine that damage, but on like a 4 second cooldown.
But it,
actually no, you had Magi, so it'd be like 4.3 seconds, 4.2. If you have blue buff,
exactly.
If you have blue buff, it would be 4.1.
What is Cosmic Drive? What exactly does it do? Is it just movement speed?
It's 30 haste.
Mm.
The most haste on any item.
Oh, I never looked at that. I looked at it, I was like, okay, it's like a bruiser-ish item.
That's the other good thing about this build over the season 10 build is you build a 450 health on it, so you can like survive a hit or two. There was no health on the build in season 10.
Yeah, just pure burst.
And like you hit just as strong, and you're also like tankier, and you're faster, and you're just like all around better.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Now everyone else is also better, so where we end up in the meta is still up in the air right now.
See, like, for instance, something like that, I think AP, like, yeah, so Cosmic Drive, if it gets 30 haste, that's a lot more ease.
Yep, the Magi's for the early stack on the Harvester passive as well, and that with the blue buff, you would have, like, 4.2 seconds, I think. Get down to 4.1 with your next item.
Which is usually way faster.
So imagine that. Used to be. Imagine how hard you're hitting on every 4.5, every 4, like, 4.6 seconds, or 4.3 seconds, or whatever.
Yeah, it's... Well, right? It also gives you the opportunity because of the like the speed and the health it gives you on top.
Yeah, makes it tough to chase
Harvester.
Down because you're getting the movement speed on the Harvester proc and the Cosmic Drive proc.
Yeah, so you
and can, because like, the build has so much haste on already, like out. Cosmic Drive has a haste ratio on the movement speed proc, so you're fucking zooming. You get like 30 flat move speed from the Cosmic Drive and then like 30% from Harvester. So good luck catching you. You're way more evasive. You hit harder. It's just everything's just better.
It sounds really, really good for her engage. Like,
yeah, the Harvester build is the best all-around build by a mile. the Luden's build, you need composition support. And the enemies also have to be immobile.
Yeah.
And like, I don't know, Riftmaker might be generally better just because of how goddamn flexible it is. Like, you can build every item in the game on Riftmaker. You can build like fucking, like the entire litany of defensive options are open to you with Riftmaker.
Yeah. At Riftmaker, you want to be more in the fight, though. That's the AP item that does true damage, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you want to be, like, more in the fight. I like
being... It's a drain type playstyle.
Does it have Omnibam?
Yep, 10%. Or 15%, actually.
Okay. Yeah, so that's her bruiser build, then, huh?
Yep. Yep.
Straight bruiser.
I've been liking it a lot. And it lets you take, like, a PTA or a Conqueror, too, so it can, like, not be useless early game as well, and build more advantages earlier.
Yeah, that might help with, like, first item against Warwick, too. Just building that right away, so you could actually 1v1 him early if you guys are, like, even.
Yeah, I'd still rather go clear speed.
Yeah.
Nash is just too good on Shyvana, in my opinion. Worth laying the mythic for. How'd you like it, by the way? Feel good?
Yeah, because, like, I mean, even if I didn't get any kills early, like, say, that, you know...
Yeah, you're just killing enough shit faster. You saw the massive lead you got. You saw, you had a 5-level lead on that Warwick. Not all that is kills. A good chunk of that is just clear speed.
Yeah, it's just...
It's just clearing differential. And since you're already looking to invade and take camps away, it works really good for your playstyle. Which is exactly what you should be doing. You keep doing that, you're diamond easy, man. Like, that. Like, I really like what I saw. Good work.
Thank
anyway,
you.
I really gotta take it up right now. So, pleasure doing business with you. Hope to see you on stream, dude.
Yeah. Yep.
Later.
Later.
Alright. Hurry. We're back.